Welcome, this is Dr. Bertalan Meskó from the Medical Futurist Institute, and I had the pleasure to publish a paper in the Journal of Medical Internet Research with Brennan Spiegel from the Cedars-Sinai Medical Center, one of the pioneers in using virtual reality for pain management for patients. The title of our paper is A Revised Hippocratic Oath for the Era of Digital Health. And in that paper, we argue that an upgrade would be needed to the oath that every medical professional still take today throughout the world. We said that the last revision took place in 1948, believe it or not, and it was introduced by the World Medical Association. Since then, there have been no major upgrades or updates to the oath. In that paper, we describe that digital health as a cultural transformation has been going on in healthcare for the last decade or so. We describe that artificial intelligence and the influx of a range of advanced technologies have started to impact the everyday practice of medicine and the delivery of care. Patients have started becoming a proactive, empowered component of healthcare, the newest member of the medical team. Physicians started losing their role of being the key holder to the ivory tower of medicine, and instead of that, becoming a sort of guide for their patients in the jungle of data and information. We describe that artificial intelligence might lead to a new paradigm shift where AI will become the newest member of the medical team, and more physicians today have to work with these advanced technologies, either when a patient comes into the practice bringing their data from the wearable health sensors, or when those physicians have to reach out to the medical decision-making support AI-based tools to make better decisions to improve the efficiency of healthcare. Because of all these changes, we think a few minor upgrades would be required into the Hippocratic Oath. A few examples would include the following. I will respect the hard-won scientific gains of those physicians, researchers, and patients in whose steps I walk, and gladly share such knowledge as is mine with those who are to follow. Another one. I will remember that there is an art to medicine as well as science, and that warmth, sympathy, and understanding may outweigh the surgeon's knife, the chemist's drug, or the programmer's algorithm. The third example, I will treat my patients in an equal level partnership, and I will not be ashamed to say I know not, nor will I fail to call in my colleagues when the skills of another are needed for a patient's recovery. And just one more example. I will respect the privacy of my patients and their data, for their problems are not disclosed to me that the world may know. We think these are modest suggestions, but it would make sure that this way the oath can remain relevant and impactful, an important event in a medical professional's life. And we only propose these suggestions so that regulatory bodies and associations like the World Medical Association might decide to include these in the next iterations. Thank you so much for your attention. And if you have any more questions for me or for my co-author, Brennan Spiegel, you can find him on Twitter at Brennan Spiegel, and you can find me on Twitter at Bercy, B-E-R-C-I. Thank you.